say, you know, when you write, be the most loving mother of your work. You know, try to get rid of those demons that tell you you're not smart enough, this isn't interesting, this is a cheap shot, you know, all of the torturing voices that are trying to stop you. You just try to get rid of those voices and just accept and encourage yourself. But then when you're revising, you know, you have to be a killer. And you have to be willing to kill your babies and get rid of what isn't what the work itself needs to make it beautiful.
A young writer needs to know that you need a job, because you're not going to make money from writing, and you're probably not going to be famous from writing. You need to have something stable in your life that allows you to survive. And poetry is your dessert. It's not the main meal.
To the young writer, I always tell writers that they should be their first reader. In that they should make sure that whatever they're writing is going to make them laugh or make them feel sad or unsettled. They should write towards that, because if they can't make themselves feel the emotion that they want, then it's going to be hard for a stranger to pick up their work and feel that as well. So write for yourself first, everybody else second.
Thanks.
Sure. Probably ran.
Find a way of feeding yourself, number one. How to do that? Marry somebody wealthy, that's always good. Or get a good job that doesn't take up your time too much. Take time away from writing. I think it's so important to find some honest way of supporting yourself as a writer.
Ask yourself, why are you doing what you're doing? There are some people who are doing it because they want to make money, which sounds weird, poetry money, but there's, I guess there's some ways of doing it. And some people, because they want academic recognition, they want to win certain awards, they want to get to a certain point, they want to be surrounded by certain kinds of poets.
Right.
You know, and mm-hmm. open up Poets and Writers and see their name 5 times. And that's fine too. Some people use it as a stepping stone to other things. They want, you know, want to be in a movie, they want a recording contract, you know, especially with the spoken word aspect, you mm-hmm. know, or they want to do voiceovers or something like that. And there's nothing wrong with any of those things if you've identified that as your reason. But if your reason has anything to do with reaching other people, then there are other places that you need to be besides the traditional poetry venues. And those places are often very hungry for you to be there.
Don't do it unless you have to do it. Yeah. No, also write and read and write and read and live and love. And be honest and try to tell the truth.
I think the main piece of advice I'd like to give young writers is that they need to overcome their fear of writing and of trying to engage with the writing community. I think this holds a lot of writers back. I think often they're not even aware of exactly what it is, but I know from speaking to young writers and from being in workshops with them that it is a very big issue. And I know that it was an issue for me as well in the very beginning. Many creative artists, including writers, don't, like I said, they don't have a clear-cut path. You know, if your father was an engineer, you know, it might be easy for you to become an engineer if that's what you want to do. But many writers are born into families where there were no writers before them. And even if there were, it's not always clear how to go about it. So I think that's really my main advice, that don't be afraid and take advantage of any opportunity that you get to publish your work or to come into contact with other writers. And these days there are more opportunities to publish work than there have ever been before because of the internet and because of the ease of communication and of exchanging work and sending work anywhere in the world. So that's my advice, to overcome that fear and go out there and meet the writing community.